Hi, I'm Marc Reguera. I'm a finance director at Microsoft. And besides my family and friends, I have two passions in life, and it's in the right order: soccer and data visualization. So I think the finance role is really evolving. I've been at Microsoft since 94, and getting a lot of data, converting into insight and influencing business leaders to make decisions. That process was cumbersome, a lot of reporting, copy and paste, looking for the data I needed. And that whole journey is long and cumbersome and could be much more efficient. A lot of the time finance people spend today is on trying to find the data they need, and once they have that data, shaping it and copy and pasting whatever views they have into a PowerPoint they present. The end result is the static deliverable that has a lot of steps that could lead to errors. Microsoft finance team has been on a journey with BI. It started a few years ago, pretty much in the mid-2000s, where we started really cleansing our data, having consistent taxonomies, and really making sure we pull the data from the single master data source. So having that foundation was very important, but we also did is that source a lot of our non-strategic activities, such as payroll, and a lot of those functions that are at source. So our finance people have the time to really play with good data and leverage the newest BI tools that got released. And with the tools we have, we can now build our views going straight to the one version of the truth and connecting our presentation layer directly into the one version of the truth. The end result is a touch-enabled, self-service, secure output that taps into the one place where IT wants us to go because they control it, it's secure, it's the taxonomy is right. And so that has been the dramatic change, going from going back and forth with a central BI group and IT to get what I want the way I want, a lot of back and forth, to a place where I can self-serve myself, tapping into a highly secure environment and building my views in minutes because that tools are very easy to use. What was also great is that we didn't require any technical skills. So in the past, I had to work with IT, with other central BI groups of excellence to create views. But what I really love about PowerView is that I don't have a technical challenge anymore. I have a formidable design challenge, which is bringing a lot of data into a simple view that can be consumed. And that's very difficult, but at least I don't have a technical challenge I used to have. I see a lot of changes in the way we do business reviews today. Most business reviews today are long. It's those marathon meetings where we go over hundreds of numbers that are in dozens of tables and slides. And after a few minutes, you see the energy going down and there is basically data overload. Our brain can only really process 3 to 5 things at a time. So now we have views that are touch-enabled, interactive, that can be consumed through a lot of different mediums, a tablet, a perceptive pixel, a surface. And so we have now a business reviews evolution from a lecture given by finance to really a dynamic conversation where the audience, because the data is consumable and they can interact with it, we can have more of a brainstorming and much more interactive and mostly, more importantly, productive meeting, because we can tackle most of the issues as we can slice and dice the data live in the meeting with all the right business leaders. What I really like about our new suite of products is that we really started seeing the one Microsoft approach. We always had Excel and PowerPoint, but now they're really connected together as my PowerPoint slide is secure, dynamic, connected to my Excel Power Pivot via SharePoint seamlessly. So we truly have a solution that incorporates all these products. 2 years ago, PowerView came in, and it was really a revolution in the way I did my job. Because it allowed me to connect my presentation output, which is PowerPoint, directly to my data. And so at Microsoft, we have adopted a model where you can have a Power Pivot loaded in SharePoint and you build a PowerPoint that is connected to that data source. But we even scaled that to over 1,200 finance folks in the field as we put PowerView on top of a tabular model that has hundreds of millions of records that are user-level secure and refresh daily centrally by IT. That has really helped me, PowerView, in connecting my presentation layer to my data layers. There is also other tools within Excel, which is obviously the most familiar BI tool that people use, such as Power Query, Power Map, and Power Pivot that came up a few years ago. I truly believe Excel 2013 is a huge breakthrough from the previous version. Getting public data was something that it was a concept I didn't even think was possible. But Power Query allows me, without having any SQL or VB skills, to really get public data, bring it in Power Pivot, and joining with internal data in minutes. I can bring it into an Excel environment and merge it with other data sources that are internal or external via Power Pivot, and even render it in Excel with Power Map, which is this amazing 3D visualization tool that can go at a very local level if you have latitude and longitude information. But now, I also have the ability to consume that in the cloud with Power BI. That means that I just need a browser to consume a lot of my PowerView so I can be traveling, logging into my portal Office 365, and interact with my data simply through a browser. But what I'm really the most excited about is something called Q&A. Q&A puts natural language on top of your data, which means you can simply type your question, sales by region, by product, for FY14 Q1, and it will show you the data with in different visuals that are typically aligned with what you're trying to do. If you're looking for countries, it will show you a map. If you are doing comparison, it will show you bars. So it's the most amazing intuitive tool that that has been launched in the last few months and that is really helping us answer any question we have in meetings. We talk a lot about big data, and what we have to remember is that the end of big data is a presentation, a story you tell with narratives and visual to business leaders. And so the outcome before were static views that we share, and we had to have usually huge appendices in case there was the question that wasn't really being able to answer with the static views. Now we have views that are dynamic and touch-enabled, so as we present, the audience can actually play on their tablet with the data and see things that were not as obvious before. Most business reviews and most business leaders consume PowerPoint, so they are used to that. Those views. What's amazing now is that we're giving them flexibility to play with the data without sending them a huge file or something custom. All we do is use a medium they're very familiar, which is a PowerPoint slide, just making it available for them to slice and dice and interact very easily in a very secure way again.